behaviours that was ingrained from an early age on both of my parents. Neither of my parents were particularly pushy towards sports.
Now, for someone who works the night shift, how is your exercise schedule going? Are you consistently able to work out regardless of your mood or the weather or how bad or good your shift was? Are you able to just get it done? Or are you on the opposite end of the spectrum and you are struggling to find the motivation, the time and the want to exercise when you're working night shift? If you fall into the category of people struggling to find the motivation to exercise on night shift, this video is for you. I want to run through a typical night shift for me, which starts at 9 p.m. and goes for 10 hours, so it goes till 7:30 a.m. So you get an idea of how I incorporate exercise when I'm doing night shift, just to get your brain moving so you can maybe start to incorporate some of these healthy habits that I've adopted into your own schedule. Now, I know this schedule won't align to everyone's night shift. If I could make a video for every one of you with every single night shift start time, trust me, I would, but there are not enough hours in the day. But stay tuned for the end of this video where I'm going to walk through some different alternative schedules to me to figure out when you should exercise and when you shouldn't. Now, just a quick disclaimer here, I'm absolutely not a personal trainer, but I am a nurse who's trying not to get stuck in the rut of eating, sleeping, working, eating, sleeping, working over and over again when I work night shift. It's not good for my waistline, it's not good for my headspace, and it's not good for my social interactions with other people. So when I'm on nights, I force myself to exercise even if I cannot be stuffed. When us night shift workers talk about exercise, it's often a conversation of when. Are we supposed to exercise right as our shift's finished? Or are we supposed to go home, get some sleep, then exercise sort of mid to late afternoon? Now, the answer to that could be based on a lot of factors. You could have to take kids to and from school. The gym that you love going to might not be open. You might have to look after elderly parents. So maybe the answer to this question is out of your hands. But for some of us, we do have a choice. We can decide if we do it when the shift's finished or we get some sleep and we exercise after that. For me personally, I think the thing to remember here is if exercise is going to jeopardize your sleep in any way, and so if you can't fall asleep, you're feeling too wired and you actually can't wind down because you've exercised too close to bedtime, I'd probably suggest switching that and start exercising in the afternoon. Remember, sleep for us is so incredibly important. We talked about it on another video, which I think it's a common mistake that night shift workers make. We just fully underestimate how much sleep we actually need for short and long-term health. So when we think about exercise for us, we really need to think about, is it starting to impact on our sleep? And if so, we probably should change it and exercise at another time in the day. Now, just before we take a good look at my shift, if you are a night shift worker, we want to help you. This channel is all about helping shift workers and night shift workers live a happier, healthier life. So if that sounds like you, please consider subscribing to this channel and give us a big thumbs up. So let's dive into my shift. As I mentioned earlier, my shift starts at 9 p.m. and goes till 7:30 a.m. So when the shift finishes, I get home anywhere between 7:30 and about 8 o'clock. When I walk in for a shift, there is absolutely no way that I want to exercise at this time. I work with some people who find that they're really motivated and they feel energized at this time to exercise, and they sign themselves up for a, you know, 8 o'clock HIIT class, and they, you know, love a workout at this time and find it actually helps them sleep. I'm the reverse of this and I just cannot exercise after a night shift. What I like to do is come home, I have a shower straight away, have something to eat, close all the blinds and pop myself into bed. So this is around, sort of probably around 9 o'clock. after I've wind down and I've, you know, maybe I've watched a little bit of TV, I've listened to some music, but I always make sure that I've got my blue light blocking glasses on during this time to sort of help my melatonin kick in, which is our sleep hormone, as I've mentioned in many, many videos before, and it really helps us wind down for sleep. So after this time, I generally wake up at midday because I need to go to the toilet. So I try to keep my eye mask on as I navigate my way to the bathroom. I then go back to sleep for as long as I can. Now, this can be anywhere between 3 o'clock and 6 o'clock. 6 o'clock is a big day, but generally I wake up about sort of 4 p.m. in the afternoon. So it's at this time where exercise begins for me. So one of the little tips that I give myself, which I've mentioned in a previous video, is as soon as I get up for bed, the first thing that I want to see is something to do with exercise. So the little trigger that I give myself is I put my sneakers and my activewear just by the door. So then when I open the door, I have to step over my activewear, which is a big no-no if I'm going to try to stick to exercise as a night shift worker. So today I felt like going for a nice walk because the sun was shining, and we've talked about it in a previous video how important vitamin D is for us as night shift workers. So I went for a really nice walk around the block. Sun was shining. I didn't even listen to any music. It was just beautiful listening to the birds. But often I listen to a podcast or music, or just even some classical music without any words is really nice for my headspace. So walking is great. Gets you outside into the sun. It doesn't exactly get your heart rate pumping. So there are a couple of things that I do in the comfort of my own home after a night shift to make this happen and to sweat a bit, I guess. So one of the things I often do is to open my laptop, have a look at YouTube, and see what sort of workout I can do in the comfort of my living room. Today, I've decided to do a yoga routine, which is some core blaster thing from Yoga with Adrian, which it just went for 12 minutes. And I streamed it from my laptop to my TV, as you can see, using a Chromecast. If you don't have a Chromecast, just simply use a HDMI cable, or even just look directly off the device that you've got, laptop, phone, and just put it in a position that you can see it. Don't overthink this. You're at home, nobody else is watching, so however you set up your environment is fine. I also realize in this video, I'm wearing activewear. Often this is not the case. Sometimes I literally roll out of bed in my pajamas and do whatever workout in my pajamas. Obviously it's not cardio based, but I say that to simply give you permission to wear whatever you want. Now on the days that I'm not really feeling like yoga or Pilates and I want to get my heart rate up a little bit more and do a bit more cardio based exercise, I set up a little home gym. That's a stretch actually to call it a home gym, but I just get some equipment around the house and I set up my own little workout sort of schedule. So I might do a bit of skipping, I do some push-ups, some sit-ups, I use some weights, and you know, this can go anywhere from 15 minutes to an hour and a bit, sort of wherever my mindset is at the time. But I try to play the music that I want to keep me motivated, and I just get it done. And I know for some people, this might not work. You might need to go to a gym where an instructor is yelling at you to keep going and to not quit. But this method really works for me. I'm in the comfort of my own home. I can wear whatever I want. I've got no one screaming at me. And I know personally that I have the motivation to do this because I know how good it is for my headspace, and I'm a much better nurse if I do the workout. So that's a big enough motivation for me. Now on the afternoons that it is pouring outside or the weather is terrible, so I can't walk, I don't want to set up my little home gym, and I'm just not feeling like yoga and Pilates, the other option that I can try is to use the exercise bike that Dan bought and currently lives in our lounge room. We really love it. We've set it up right opposite the TV, and Dan's connected his PlayStation there. So he plays PlayStation while he's riding the bike. I'm terrible at PlayStation, didn't grow up with gaming, so that's not for me. But I just watch an episode of a show on Netflix, or I listen to an audiobook that I've really started to get into, and I find that I love it. Our machine sets a timer for half an hour automatically, and I don't quite know how to change that. And that is perfect. Half an hour on the bike, a little bit of weights, a couple of stretches, and you're done. Now, if you don't like the sound of any of that, had a swimming sound. It's something I've recently got back into, and it's much easier, I must admit, with short hair. But it gives you a real huff and puff. It's a great stretch. The non-weight bearing is beautiful, probably in comparison to running, which this body doesn't really run. So I find that swimming is a really great alternative for me. Though I don't love the change room setup and being cold and wet all the time, I find the benefits of swimming massively outweigh the negatives. So if you're trying to figure out how you can exercise as a night shift worker, maybe swimming's something you could adopt. Now, it's highly likely you don't work exactly the same night shift schedule as me. So I want to walk you through some alternative work schedules so you can figure out if it's best to exercise after you've had a sleep, or it's okay to get into a workout right when your shift's finished. Now, to do this, I want to walk through this little table that I constructed. So you're just going to have to use your imagination a little bit if your shift time doesn't exactly match to what I've got listed here. But let's just run through a couple. So if your shift is from 7 p.m. till 7 a.m., so it's a 12-hour shift, I would probably work out before the shift, but I've got a little asterisk here that if you are working a 12-hour night shift, this is massive. It's hard on your body, and these shifts are really tough going. So if you are only working maybe two or three of these 12-hour night shifts in a row, really be very kind to yourself during this time, and I wouldn't do anything really intensive cardio-based. I'd just be a little bit kinder and maybe stick to the walks or some yoga or Pilates stretching. The next shift I've got listed here is the 9 p.m. till 7 a.m. Now, this is the shift that I've just run through now that mirrors mine pretty much. And as I've just mentioned, I exercise before the shift. I find that I'm way too tired in the morning and I just like to go to sleep. The next shift is 11 p.m. till 8 a.m. Now, I think it's probably best to exercise before the shift, but as I've talked about in previous videos, we do like to expose ourselves to a little bit of sunshine while we're on night shift to increase those vitamin D levels for good, healthy bones and healthy muscles. So if you are going to exercise before that 11 p.m. mark, you know, can you maybe do it a little bit earlier in the day when there is still a little bit of sunshine? That's why I've said before they shift. The next shift I've got is 12 a.m. So you're starting at midnight and you're working all through the night and you finish at 10 a.m. Again, similar to the shift that I've said before the shift, if you can get a little bit of sunshine, but I do understand that 12 a.m. is quite late to start, so you just sort of do the best you can. I know a friend of mine who does work this shift, and when the shift finishes at 10 a.m. they think it's a really nice time because the sun's shining and they do like to embrace the sunshine and get some exercise before they hit the hay and get to sleep. So that might be an option for you too. The next shift I've got listed there is 3 a.m. till lunchtime. So you're working until 12 p.m. Again, similar to what I've just mentioned, the sun will be shining when you finish your shift. You are finishing at lunchtime. The world is awake. Your family are probably awake. So this might be a really nice time to exercise. The next shift I've got there is 7 p.m. and you're finishing in the middle of the night, 3 a.m. Now, personally, I've never done this shift, but personally, I think that I'm not going to want to exercise in the middle of the night. This is when our body is really ready for sleep, and I think trying to find the motivation to exercise at this time would be pretty challenging. So I think it's probably best to go home, get some sleep, and then maybe exercise in the afternoon, anywhere from, you know, maybe 2:30, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, try to fit in a workout then. So I hope this video has inspired you to fit in some exercise during your next night shift. I very much appreciate you sticking around for this long. Again, consider subscribing to this channel, giving us a big thumbs up, and we really appreciate the support.